Hey guys, what's going on? Bobby here, and welcome back to a brand new video. Today we are here at the legendary Road America in Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin for another round of the Skip Barber Formula Race Series. Yesterday's practice was awesome. We actually had mixed conditions. In the first practice it was wet, and then it dried up as we went out there. We were out on rain tires. Got a really good feel for what the wet line is supposed to be. And then in the second practice it was completely dry, a lot of grip. So with varying weather conditions this rest of the weekend, it was a good opportunity to learn both tracks. Just got out of the car for qualifying today, right ahead of race one later today, and we got my first ever pole position in the Skip Barber Formula Race Series thanks to a little bit of draft down the back straightaway. So really awesome day so far. Really looking forward to getting back behind the wheel for race number one. Whatever the weather may be, really looking forward to getting back out there and starting from the front row pole position for the first time.
And the race winner, a person very familiar to the Skip Barber Racing School, a 226.8, the winner of the race in style. Let's hear it for Bobby Krug! Bobby, we were talking earlier about how you tend to do well on a microphone. You tend to give a good speech. Take your hands out of your pocket. There's people watching. Just hands by the side. That's what makes you look strong. There you go. It's Skip Barber Racing School. We have to teach these things, okay? It's not just like, it's almost pro. Okay, now I'm stepping back. So Bobby, when we talked about this earlier, what the fans don't know is that we talked about how you do a good microphone interview, and your response was, yeah, and I'm gonna show that to you Saturday afternoon. Speechless. Bobby, tell us about the start.
I was actually really concerned about the start. Mikel, Elvis, all the guys that were behind me, I knew that they were just going to be a hungry pack of dogs trying to go for it. And I've seen how some of these races go, and usually it's 3-4 wide in turn number one. And so just kept looking at my left side mirror, and I saw that I was able to clear and kind of have the track to myself going to turn one. And at that point, it was like put my head down and see what I can do here. And fortunately, when I came back around that first lap, I looked back and it's literally, I mean, it's just me and Mikel primarily. So I felt pretty confident at that point that we could just make it a two-car race for the lead, and the rest is history.
So you and Mikel, you were together for a while, so I'm sure you were looking in the mirrors to see where he was strong and where you had some opportunities yourself to be faster. What were the spots that Mikel was stronger? he is 100% correct when he is the latest breaker in turn five, because he would be a little dot in the mirror and all of a sudden there's this big angry formula car in the mirror and I'm like, where did he, how? Like, teleportation I don't think exists yet in this current day of age, but he brought it from the foreign lands and he's using it here. But no, like he said, he was really good in the cornering, some of the technical stuff, and it just seemed like I was able to get the power down and be able to pull away a little bit. And you know, in the last probably five or six laps, I really had a pretty sizable gap. And so at that point, it was just flip cruise control on, turn Sirius XM to Hair Nation, and just cruise. So it was a pretty calm, smooth, comfortable couple last laps. And then getting the checkered flag here, it meant a lot. One final note, and then I'll let you ask another question or go to the next thing. VIR, I got the win at VIR. It was my first win, and it was after the unfortunate situation with Elvis and Jeshua, two amazing drivers in the series that are going to move on to big and better things. We're going to be talking about them forever. And their situation, and that led to my win. It kind of felt like a fluke. And this one I had to work for, and this one felt earned, and this one feels amazing.
That's an amazing feeling.
Is this your first time at Road America?
As a driver, yes.
As a driver, what did you do before that?
The media stuff for the touring car team. So, social media marketer for Skip Barber Racing School. If you don't already like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, YouTube, all that stuff. Smash that like button. I was here last year doing a lot of video stuff. So and a lot of sim work. That combination, it really helped me just to be able to know the track a lot more. But going around all the corners and filming, I knew how legendary this track was and respected a ton. And this has been a bucket list track for me to drive on. So never would have thought I would have been able to win here, which is crazy. Let me just take a mental photo of what this looks like, because this is pretty cool with the sunset and everything. But that was my only prior experience here besides a lot of sim work.
Tell us, what's your favorite corner?
That's a tough one. I like the whole back part of the track, the kink to Canada corner. It's super fast, and on that qualifying lap that we watched where I was able to pull together the really good drafts, I mean, I got out of the kink and I looked down and I was going like 10 kilometers an hour faster than I had all entire weekend. I was like, whoa. And this is just that whole section and just how tight it feels, and then Canada corner, you just carry a lot of speed, float a lot of speed in there. Just an awesome section. But this whole track as an entire facility is awesome, and I really hope this isn't the last time that I get to race here, because this place is outstanding.
I can see and feel, everyone can feel the energy coming out of you as you describe the track. So really, everybody that has not yet driven the track, you've got to find a way to get in a race car. Who would you like to thank?
First and foremost, Skip Barber Racing School, the DeMonte family, all the awesome instructors that we have here. Wouldn't have been able to get on this spot right here without them, especially Mike Ogren, Carter Fartuck. They really put me in the right mindset going into this one, and all props to them for that. Enrique, Josh, Quentin, those guys, I never see them standing around. They're always doing something to make these cars as good as they can for everybody else. And I would go to say that these are the three hardest working techs probably in this paddock. I can't say enough awesome things about those guys. Big props to the TC guys. They help us out a lot as well. I mean, when things are in a pinch, we're one big family here. And can't say enough about those guys as well. And just the management that we have here at Skip Barber. I mean, this is the best racing school that you can go to. And these guys, everyone on the podium, all the drivers out there, we're going to take the racing world by storm, guys. This is our opportunity here. This is just the start. And we're not finishing anytime soon.
Congrats. Thank you so much for all of that. From Bobby Krug, I told you he did a good interview.
Okay, then.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, race tomorrow.
Once again, thanks everybody. We'll see you tomorrow. Bobby. Two wins in two races at Road America. Is this now your favorite racetrack in the world?
Yeah, I doubled my amount of career wins in the series in one weekend, so that's pretty good. No, I never would have expected that coming here. So I love Road America. I've, you know, even in practice when I was still trying to learn the track, fourth and sixth in practice, I still loved it. It just seemed like a really, I don't want to say an easy track to learn, but it came very easy to me. So I love this place.
So one guy that was on the podium yesterday, Mikel Gabe, he was with you at the start. He had the pole, and you guys came through turn one together. What was it like racing with Mikel during the opening lap?
Oh, me and Mikel, it seems like me and him are like magnets. We're always racing with each other. So I knew exactly what to expect from him, and he's a class act guy, and I knew once he got out to the front and I tried battling him a little bit, I was just going to try hanging with him. And then one guy that kind of came out of nowhere was Nicky Glazier. I mean, second weekend for him in this series, and he's improved a lot. So to be able to battle out with him too, that was really cool up until that full course.
Yeah, he pushed you back to third, didn't he?
He did, yeah. I was like, I really wasn't expecting that out of Nicky, but I knew that he was showing really good pace yesterday. I knew he was going to be a threat, but wasn't really expecting it that early on. So going from, you know, second place to third that early on and then trying to see what they were going to do, I was a little nervous.
So what do you like about Road America best, about the racetrack, about driving this track?
That's a good question. I experienced it two different ways. Yesterday, it was kind of a dominating race for me, leading every lap. This was the first time, you know, I remember in the driver's meeting talking about how everyone here in the driver world was kind of all equipped. They've had the experience in traffic. And I'm thinking, you know, I don't think I made a pass until today, except for, you know, qualifying. But it's a good track. It's a really good track. It's a fun track to be able to go out there and drive. That's what I feel like I was doing yesterday, is just driving it. And it felt really calm and relaxing. It just has a really good flow. And then today, just the chemistry and how it creates a lot of passing opportunities for guys. So kind of a draft track, and especially in these Skip Barber Formula cars, it's an awesome place. Unfortunately, just, you know, high risk, high reward kind of thing presents itself here a lot more. But I think for the majority, the guys did really good trying to take care of all the equipment.
Well, we can't wait to get back. So who would you like to thank?
First and foremost, Skip Barber Racing School, the DeMonte family. The Skip Barber staff here is incredible. The higher-ups, the instructors, the techs especially for all the hard work they put in. I got to thank my dad's here this week, and I forgot him yesterday, and I felt bad for that. So can't thank him enough for giving me the racing bug at an early age, watching it on TV. I never thought I'd be here actually doing it. But it's awesome to have him here this weekend, the family back home in St. Louis, the karting family that I got back there. It's just a lot of, you know, it says that it takes an army to get one guy up there, and it certainly has with me. So a lot of people to thank. We'd be here all night, and I'm not going to do that to everybody, but a lot of people to thank. So appreciate everybody.
Congrats again, Bobby. I would imagine that everybody that has stood on this podium has a similar story. It takes a kingdom to get a race driver on the racetrack. So once again, your top three, James Lawley, Elvis Rankin, and Bobby Krug.
Oh, he still got some.
Oh, there's Quick.
Nice. Too many bees.
Congrats, guys. Thanks, everybody. Thanks
bees.
For such a great show.
I don't want to get stung.
Thanks to Road America and all the track staff, concessions, gift shop. We appreciate everybody that makes this happen in Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin. We'll see everybody at our next event, next Skip Barber Formula Car Race Series event at Sebring, Florida.
All right, guys, that is a wrap on this Road America vlog. We got the pole, and we got the win yesterday, and we got the win today. What an amazing race, amazing weekend here at Road America. Now one of my favorite racetracks in the country. Just incredible, and I'm not gonna keep you guys too long at this end of the video. You guys saw the post-race talk, but it's on the podium, but incredible weekend. Can't thank Skip Barber Racing School enough. If you're wanting to take your start in racing, check them out, skipbarber.com. What an incredible day. Can't thank all of my partners and sponsors, everybody, Global Force Kart Sport, Gateway Kartplex, Margate Racing, all the guys back home for getting me here at this point. Special shout out to my dad for making the drive up here and hanging out. It's really cool to share this moment with him. And we don't have a Matt Zagaitis, we don't have a Brendan Lauer, but we did have a Jeremy Franco this weekend. So huge thanks to him for coming out here and helping document this incredible weekend. So can't say much more than that, guys. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you in the next one.